Pano-Mounts PPTM 7950 phase change thermal pads. Let's take a look. Keep in mind they did send me these tray out and make the video on. These specific ones are 40 by 40 by 0.2 millimeters, 8.5 watt per meter Kelvin. They're made of a thermally conductive phase change material. That means that once they get up to a certain temperature, they become more liquid. So it should fill all of the gaps between the heatsink and CPU. The phase change thermal pads could be an interesting alternative to standard thermal paste. It does include some accessories in the package. You've got a little brush for removing dust and such, a screwdriver, and various tools they could use for phones or something. I did end up using the tools to apply the material because I had some challenges with installation, which we'll get to. The pads do have some information on them, but it doesn't include any specific instructions. Their main installation guide says, wipe the CPU surface clean. Of course, you're gonna clean the heatsink as well. Measure the size of the phase change pad and cut it to size. However, you've got the two tabs on there. Each side has a different type of plastic. Installation was pretty challenging for me. I tried two different ways and I still had issues with getting full coverage on the CPU. The first computer, Intel i7-6700, pretty easy with the heat spreader. It's just a rectangle, so no huge issue. But with the thermal material, it has two different types of plastic on it. One's a harder plastic, one's a softer plastic. In that case, I removed the softer plastic first. Here's my custom cut piece of the phase change material. This side is ready to go, so I'm just going to put it down on the CPU like that. And also, getting it to fully remove off of the plastic either side can be challenging. I think the areas with the stickers that give you a little bit of information, that's the most difficult part. So if you can avoid using that area of the thermal material, that's probably good because you'll have a much easier time removing all of the plastic from it and applying it to the CPU. It shouldn't be a huge issue if you don't get like completely full coverage, but considering it's a phase change material, I would leave a little bit of extra room maybe so that when it does swap into more of a liquid, it doesn't flow out too much. On my older build, the heatsink is not ideal for this material, I think, because there are really large gaps between the heat spreader and also the heat pipes. So given this is 0.2 millimeters, might not be enough. There could be air gaps, but that said, it worked just fine. The temperatures seemed all right between the original material and the new pads. For the newer computer setup, this was even more challenging with installation because the Ryzen 9900X doesn't have a rectangle or square heat spreader. There's little areas that are cut out from it, so it's a lot more difficult to use some type of pad to get full coverage. And I did get a few gaps here and there. In this case, I removed the harder plastic first, pushed it onto the CPU, and a portion of it did stay on there, but then I had some issues again near where the stickers are to give you some information on installation. I did try to use some of the additional material, scrape it off with the included tools and apply it to the CPU, but it doesn't really stick well to the CPU. I'm not really sure how I could improve the installation too much, but in general, I think I got it to work well enough to at least function. They say that it'll take about 1 or 2 days to lower temperatures. After a few days, it looks like the temperatures have evened out a little bit. I'm doing way too much on the main computer, but it hit almost 83 degrees Celsius, which is a little bit above my original test, but it's not under the same conditions, so it's hard to say. But for the older computer, it looks like there is an actual benefit between the phase change material and whatever original thermal paste I had on there. It might have been a few years since I had changed that, but a few degrees difference after a few days, even just with the phase change material when it was originally applied and currently, while I'm running Prime 95 on it, 58 degrees versus 56 degrees maximum, not too bad. That said, it's really difficult for me to tell if it does make a huge difference in temperatures because there's so many variables involved. These phase change materials should last for a long time compared to standard thermal paste. So that could be a potential benefit for you if you have a server or something. Installation was challenging for me. Definitely need to really, really think about what you're doing and how you're going to apply it properly. Depending on your CPU, depending on your ability to finally apply materials and work with small things, this could be a very fun project to try out this material and see if it works well for you. Thanks to Pano-Mounts for sending me this kit. Scott of Tech, I suppose. See ya.